Hey guys, here's a quick video about Halloween coming up. Everybody's getting pretty excited. True and I are getting pretty pumped. We got our tickets purchased for Halloween Horror Nights, and one of the scare zones for this year is based on what you're looking at, trick or treat. And so I had not seen it before, and when I saw that come out, I've been trying to watch the movies I haven't watched already to try to get more familiar with the characters or the storyline, whatever it may be. This year they have The Shining, Ashford vs. the Evil Dead, American Horror Story. Remember the other one? What's the other one I'm forgetting?
Invasion? Wait, what?
Invasion's a scare zone. What's
Oh.
the other, the big house?
Wait, what scare zone?
Oh, there's the Blumhouse one, which is based on Sinister, Insidious, and The Purge. So that'd be really cool. I feel like I'm still no, American Horror Story. Oh no, that's four. That's the four IP other, based directly on movies. I feel like there's a fifth one that I'm missing. I'm still missing one. Either way, I'll put a little on the screen there in the video. Which houses I'm looking for anyways. So anyways, because of that, I had not seen this Trick or Treat movie. It looked kind of cool. My understanding is it was also produced by Blumhouse. So I went and found it on the internet, whatever, for my daughter and us, for True and I to watch. And very early on into the movie, she said, "Oh, I've seen this before." So either way, it was her second time or whatever, but watching this movie was very cool. This character Sam here is sort of like the character that ties all the scenes together. The whole movie is sort of like four individual stories being told, but they all come together at some point. It's really cool. It's a really good idea. It's a typical horror movie. Nice, 130 minutes or so. Just not 130 minutes, an hour and a half, 90 minutes. 130 would be pretty long. Either way, it's fun, and I know when you think of horror, you think of some of these iconic figures like Jason or Michael Myers or Freddy Krueger, Leatherface, Pinhead, stuff like that, where you hope that when you create this movie, it lives on forever. And the reason why that happens is because you've got this figure, this supernatural sort of can't be killed scary monster that you've created that will go on forever and ever. So anyways, I think that they were very successful in doing so when creating Sam. And True and I were sort of cruising around town today, and she saw a friend of hers, I think, post on Instagram or Snapchat or something. It
Instagram.
was on Instagram.
So
A they
basically
were at
what my
the local Toys R Us.
can I explain it?
Yeah, go ahead.
So basically my friend, he was over at Toys R Us and put on his story on something how nothing good is at Toys R Us, and then he said never mind when he saw stuff from Voltron and Rick and Morty. And then he was filming a video or something, like there was a video showing all of the horror stuff, and obviously he has never watched Trick or Treat, so he didn't know what it was. But then I started freaking out because I was like, wait, that's at Toys R Us, so.
So after seeing the movie and already being excited and getting amped up, and it's officially fall, it's the second day of September, so we can start like celebrating a month ahead because that's what crazy people do when they're fanatics about a certain holiday. Everybody's getting ready for, everybody loves the fall, and then going into the winter. So you have Halloween and Thanksgiving and obviously the fall colors and going into Christmas, and it's just a great time of year. So we're super excited. When I saw that they were doing the scare zone, and then I saw some of the Tim Tracker's videos, he goes and always usually goes there once a week and will do an update, and last year I saw him and Jin, and they were at the parks probably three or four or five different times throughout Halloween Horror Nights. It seemed like they were always there, which was awesome to be able to go so many times. And I think they actually made one out a trip out to Universal on Hollywood as well, which was cool. So it's fun following along with those guys. And anyways, the cool thing about Tim going is I've been able to sort of stay up and see what's going up. And we're pass holders as well. We just live farther away, so we can't go all the time. We're about an hour and a half away. So we could be going and seeing for ourselves what's going up. But I know Tim's local, so it's easier for him. That's what he does. So it's awesome to be able to follow along with them as well and sort of knowing, we're getting amped up over here, watching, getting ready. So anyways, super excited for this scare zone. She says, "Hey, I think they got a Sam character at Toys R Us." I'm Googling, I'm looking around, trying to figure out what character they're referring to. Either way, the Sam character, if you don't know anything about him, he's sort of the. So, anyways, he's basically like a hero for his holiday, where, I'm gonna put some scenes from the movie so you'll kind of get an idea of what he's at. What?
Basically, who that is a representation. It's like, no, personification of Halloween, but put into one character. So if you read the back, it like just read the back.
Okay, well, maybe we'll do that here. I'll put it up on the screen what the words are, and you can read it yourself. Either way, to me, my take on the character, without reading anybody else's words or whatever, is that he's sort of like a hero for the holiday. It even says that sort of in the description when you read about it, where you basically don't respect Halloween, don't disrespect Halloween, excuse me. As long as you respect the holiday and you're participating in whatever, then you won't be visited from Sam. But in the movie, it's the ones that sort of disrespect the holiday and aren't happy about it, that he sort of goes after. So there's a very cool scene with the bus driver when they're having a nice battle with Sam, and something happens. I don't want to, I guess I could give the spoiler. Sam goes to kill the bus driver, the old man in the house, and he accidentally stabs him in a candy bar. He must have had like a candy bar in his pocket, and he went to go stab him, and he ends up stabbing the candy bar. And so now that Sam sees this as the man has given Sam a piece of candy, the whole trick or treat scenario, he's now happy and he goes and he sort of packs up and leaves. And after that, you see the man with his butt kicked and all bandaged up, and he's out there handing out candy because he
You
realizes.
should do spoiler warning because
I
I feel
did. I
like
said spoiler alert. I said it. So if you're still listening and I spoiled it, my bad. I said it. Either way, it's cool. We like it. I definitely think this is one of the characters, like I was saying before, with Jason and Freddy and Michael Myers, Pinhead, all the likes of those type of characters that'll go down. I know there's all kinds of other ones out there as well, but those are just the ones that come to mind quickly that are obviously extremely popular. And I think they've definitely done it. So we've got this character. We're gonna open it up. We're gonna check it out. There's the back of the box. He carries around this half-eaten, translucent, or pumpkin candy, whatever, that he uses actually as a weapon and kill as well. There's his bag of treats that he drags along with him. But it's very creepy and very cool. And the scare zone at Halloween Horror Nights is going to be awesome. It already looks so cool. So let's see about taking this out of the box. All right, so I'm going to open this up and get this out. And I will play. I'll get some clips to show in this video as well. And I think what I'm going to do as well, we went to Michael's. There was Michael's over by Toys R Us, and they already had some Halloween stuff out, which was pretty awesome. Ooh, that's a cool back. I don't know if you can see those pumpkins back in there. That's cool. A lot of pumpkins. Anyway, there's Sam. Let's get this plastic piece off. Ooh. Whoa. All right, so there's that. This is very well made. This was, oh, this is so cool. Whoa, he doesn't stand. Does he stand very well? Ooh. Oh, there we go. His head articulates. His arms do as well, and his hands right there. This turns as well. I don't know. The legs, nope. So, 5 point, the head rotates, the arms, and the wrists are the points of articulation there. And let's get this out of the way. That just messes it up. You can see here the candy. If that's showing up very well. I know it's sort of. And that's going to go in his hand. It's very cool looking. burlap sack type head. So cool. Cool eyes. This is his candy bag. You can see a sack there. It'll go in this hand. See if I can get that in there. So, anyways, I'll play some clips to sort of show you him in action in the movie, so you can get an idea if you're not already familiar with him. Anyways, what I was trying to say is we went to Michael's. And Michael's has already got their Halloween decorations out for purchase, arts and crafts and supplies and stuff. And I've never seen it before, but you know how they always have those Christmas villages that you can buy to sort of put on your mantle. You know, that was the whole idea. Most people don't have, fireplaces here in Florida where we're at. But if they do, they can put it on their mantle. If not, people will put them, on their bar area or something like that, or on a table or an entryway or whatever. And so Michael's, which I've never seen before, they now have a whole collection, which I'll play some video from at the end here, of basically like a Halloween town, a haunted house, a biker part, or some like carnival scene areas. It's really cool, and they've got it all set up so you can really get a good idea of all the pieces, and it's really fun. I would buy it all if I could, but of course they're expensive, so it's one of those collections where you buy, maybe one or two a year, and next year maybe you can get a couple more. So hopefully the whole entire collection of those lasts, just as the Halloween do, or excuse me, the Christmas ones do, as they come back every year. Hopefully the Halloweens do as well. And maybe they have been, and I've just never noticed. Maybe this is just the first time I'm finally getting around to it. They've been around for years for all I know. But anyways, it's very cool. All right, well, here's Sam. What do you think, True? Check him out. She's giving up some sort of sign, saying it's cool. Okay.
The okay sign,
That's very neat. Let's check it out. There's Sam. Anyways, super excited about this. We have a we do the loot crates the most, and there's a there was the Comic Con, New York City Comic Con, from I think it was 2 years ago, that they had a crate, a special crate exclusive for the New York City Comic Con that was all horror themed, and you could only get it there, of course, until they didn't sell out, and they had some. They ended up releasing on the site, and I bought one of the boxes afterwards and had it shipped in. I think it was like a $50 crate, and it came with some pretty sweet items, but it was all horror themed. And it had like an umbrella that was the Umbrella Corporation umbrella from Resident Evil, but it had a really cool Chucky doll that's just like this right here. There's another iconic figure that I managed to not mention before, but Chucky. It's a little bit taller than this, but it would be perfect in a side-by-side collection sitting on a shelf. So, anyways, here's Sam. Hope you guys like it. I hope you guys are excited about the Halloween holiday coming. Maybe you're going to Halloween Horror Nights. Comment down below. Tell us what your favorite house was. If you've seen this movie, maybe what your favorite part of seeing the movie was. Just thought it'd be cool to do a quick video. It's been a while since I did anything toy related. Well, I guess if you count the loot crates, but I meant we were talking about it where we were at. Toys R Us, haven't done any blind box openings. I'm like, man, this is such a cool figure. It sure would be cool to do that and talk about Sam. So here we are, talking about Sam. Anyways, thanks for watching. Give it a thumbs up, subscribe down below. See you guys next time.